Good morning, everyone. I hope that you are having an awesome Thursday, as we would say sometimes, a thriving Thursday. We're here back for day two of 31 Days of Power with your girl Tiffany. That's me. Don't forget, let other people know that this broadcast is taking place. Share it. If you are catching the replay, please type in replay so I know who you are, so I can tell you thank you for tuning in even after this was actually aired. Again, please share it. Let people know that I'm here because I want to help as many people as I can help. I want to help. And so let's share it because a lot of times, you know, I don't want to be the best kept secret. Let's share it. Also, I want to tell you to be sure to set your notifications for Facebook so that way you don't miss the lives. So if you are, let's say, available to watch the lives and you may have forgotten, the Facebook will actually notify you when I go live. So definitely set your notifications so that way you know when I go live. Give me some water. I want to thank everyone who tuned in to day one and even those who caught the replay. Thank you so much. Those of you who shared it, I truly appreciate you. And so we're about to get started. So day two, remember, for those who are tuning in for the first time, the 31 Days of Power is based off my book, Lady of Power. If you're interested in getting the book, you can get it at tiffanydkelly.com or just ladyofpower.com. But I'm doing it based on the 31 days in my 31 inspirations in my book. But today is day two. We're going to focus on day two right now. Day two of 31. And this particular inspiration is titled, Take Action, Make Bold Steps, Be Prepared. So you say you're ready to end the dieting cycle, right? How bad do you want it? Do you want it bad enough to give up that favorite fast food restaurant that you frequent? Ooh, I'm touching on some toes. I know. Security. Bad enough that you're willing to carry your meals for lunch and opt out of the daily lunch run with your coworkers. Y'all know I'm talking the truth. Do you want it bad enough to not let your hair be the reason you won't sign up for that fitness class? Yeah, there's still some of us out there who won't sign up for a fitness class and won't get fit because they're worried about the hair. Yes, I went there. The journey is not for the faint at heart. It is for you, for all my women, Lady of Power. It is time to commit to a lifestyle makeover. Type in the comments, lifestyle makeover, because it's a major makeover. And if I could just interject for a quick moment, I remember when I started my journey, I never forget it. I was just got my meal plan from my trainer. I'm like, yes, I got this. It's my friend decides she wants to go out to dinner. And at that time it was Copeland's Cheesecake Bistro in the Lang Station here in Atlanta. And I'm like, really? Like, what am I gonna eat in there? But I had to be smart because I know I had a goal to achieve. So I know I was doing a total makeover. That means I was shifting my mindset and the things that I used to do, the choices that I made, I knew that I couldn't continue to do that if I wanted to be healthy. This makeover, this new health and wellness journey requires you to dig deep. I want you to type in the comments, dig deep. Dig deep within to loose the power which God has given you to take action, make bold steps, and be prepared. See, God has given us that power. It's already within us, but it's up to us to take action and release that power, unleash it. In the Bible, James 2, verse 24 reads, you see that a person is considered righteous by what they do and not by faith alone. So you know that old saying, faith without works is dead? And I was looking at the Message Bible last night and it talks about, I kind of wrote the notes down. It says, faith expresses itself in works. So type that. Faith expresses itself in works. So if you believe that God has put you on this earth for a mighty purpose, you believe that God wants you to take care of his temple, you believe that even in those challenging times that God is still going to take care of you, if you believe that, then your actions are going to show it. So faith without works is dead. And so this scripture talks about that. So Let me keep going because I'll go in, y'all. Let me stay focused on the paper. Okay, let me focus. Let me read. Being prepared means putting your beliefs of what you say you are capable of doing into action. So a lot of us, we know we can do it, but we're not doing it. It's time to put it in action. That's why I would, you know, I have a video on my YouTube channel. It's basically talking about discovering your why, your real why. Like why? Like what would a healthy and fit life bring you? What is that thing that's gonna keep you going when you don't feel like going, even though you know you can do it, but you're not doing it? You may be wondering, what does that mean? It means winning on this journey to weight loss success or health and wellness success will require eating out less. Yes, it will, especially when you first start your journey. It will require you to eat out less when you first start, because you have to be able to build that willpower to not give in. Trust me, I've walked this journey already. Making better choices when you do eat out, that's that self-talk and remembering your goals. Creating a weekly schedule for working out and or getting a personal trainer. Like, for example, I sat down today for this month and set, and on my calendar right here on my desk, I have already set out my workout days for the month, and they're not touching. But I mean, that those are my days that I'm dedicating each week to take care of my body. Signing up with a coach, you know, or finally, but not the least, but consistently planning and preparing healthy meals that help you reach your goals. And so even if you're someone who said, well, hey, Tiffany, girl, I don't cook, you got to start somewhere. If it's someone who actually does meal prep and they can cook the meals for you, those healthy meals for you, there are a lot of those type of companies out here. But even for yourself, if you start out small, where it's like, say, okay, for the first couple of weeks, you're gonna prep at least three meals. You got to start somewhere and build upon that, because goals require sacrifice. You have to make a sacrifice. So I want y'all to type that in the comments. Goals require sacrifice. That's one of my favorite lines. That's one of my favorite. I need to put that on a t-shirt too. Goals require sacrifice. Okay, I'm going to continue. Here's another part of this. Do you have people around you who would want you to fail? Do they expect you to keep repeating the dieting cycle? Because, you know, a lot of times, you know, every year we say we're going to lose weight, and we got those people that say, yeah, girl, whatever, you said it last year. Do they say things like, yeah, she said that before. Let's see how long she'll last this time. She'll never lose that weight. Now is the time to shut down your naysayers. Matter of fact, I'm going to take it a step further. Now is the time to shut down your own negative self-talk. Hello. Because sometimes some of us, our own negative self-talk will just jack us up and mess up, derail our whole journey, because we don't believe in ourselves. And so I dare you, I challenge you to shut down the negative chatter, to shut down the naysayers. You know, I wrote my book here. It says, or some people that we could also call them haters. Shut down your haters. This ain't their journey, it's yours. Don't worry about what they say and what they think. You know what you have to do for yourself. You know the calling that God has put on your life. It's time for you to get moving. Make your actions bold. Put bold in the comments, y'all. Bold. Make those actions bold. Bold enough for people to take a second look at what you're accomplishing. I remember when I started my journey, I'll never forget it, one of my first schools here in Atlanta. And, you know, I started losing weight. I was working with a trainer. And because I guess, like, you know, we have, you know, a lot of people like me, you know, and my other colleagues, you know, we start these weight loss, you know, journeys, and we say we're going to do it, and then we don't do it. And people look at you like, yeah, you know, she says she eating right. She said she's doing X, Y, and Z. And then when the weight started falling off, there was a rumor that I had surgery. I was like, really? This young lady actually came back to apologize to me and say, you know, Tiffany, I'm sorry. I see all the work that you're doing, that you're putting in. She said, but I just knew you had surgery. Surgery? Really? So these are things that people will do. Be ready for it. Make your steps so bold that people will take notice. Like, dog, what is she doing? And guess what? It turned around and inspired her to actually get her health on track. So you never know who's watching you. Take bold steps. For example, sign up at the local gym, join a fitness group, heck, even creating your own fitness group if you need to. Be bold. Sign up with a trainer, coach, dietitian, or research online for resources that support meal planning and exercise tips, nutrition, or even look. You can even, hey, reach out to me. The point of this is that make the necessary steps, the actions that will yield you results. No more excuses. A part of being bold on this journey means that you'll have to prepare your meals for the week. Hello, I already talked about that. This is the key to successful weight loss. 80% of weight loss is in the food that you eat. The food is key. Everyone type that in there. The food is key. The food is key. Planning your meals and carrying them with you every day will lower your chances of selecting foods that won't help you reach your weight loss goals. Select a day you'll commit to shopping. Yes, it means get organized. Type that too. Get organized. I will get organized. Because along this journey to be successful, you can't do it by flying by the seat of your pants. You can't do it on a whim. You can't do it cold. You got to be prepared. You got to set yourself up for success. Just like when we actually have our jobs and we're going in for an interview, we don't go in not knowing about the company. No, we study, we're prepared, we go in ready for success. Apply the same thing to your life, your own health. Take care of you. All right, I'm sorry, y'all. I got a little extra. Okay. I get excited. boldly create a weekly schedule to make fitness a part of your life. Dedicate yourself and be determined to stick to your regimen. Type that in the comments. Stick to your regimen. Stay the course. It's important. Remember, you no longer want to diet. It's not a diet, y'all. This is a new lifestyle. It's a healthy lifestyle makeover for permanent health and wellness success. The cycle is no longer an option because a lot of us have done the cycle. And hey, I've done it too. Off again, on the wagon, off the wagon, up and down. But it has at some point, you have to end the cycle. Be inspired and motivated to transform your mindset and take bold actions that no longer mirror the power of a powerless woman. Say this to yourself. Here's today's affirmation for those of my ladies out there. I am a lady of power who is capable of reaching my goals. I will take action by making bold steps because I am prepared. Now, I know I said a lot, so if you have the book, you can go back and read it. But I will take bold steps. I will take action by making bold steps because I am prepared. But the biggest key, too, is remembering that you are a lady of power and you are capable of reaching your goals. But you have to be prepared. You got to take action. You got to take action. You got to believe in yourself. I want to encourage you all. You can do this. There's nothing that you can't do. The power lies within you. God has given us that power. Tap into it. Make it happen. Make this the year that you stop the cycle. Make this the year that you do what you do this year. You're going to just build on it next year and you won't be starting from scratch, from square one again. So thank you for tuning into this for day two of 31 Days of Power with your girl, Tiff. Remember to share. Let's help some other people get healthy along with us. And if you would like to pick up the book again, you can go to tiffanydkelly.com. But if not, you can also just tune in here for all 31 days, or if you catch the replay, and just continue to walk this journey with us and get yourself powered up for an awesome and amazing new year. Have a great day, y'all. See you tomorrow. And remember, look for that win every day. Oh, wait a minute. Let me see here. Let me see if I have any comments. I know some comments in here somewhere. I was looking in here. Okay, y'all. Have a good day.